Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 25th September, on the front page you have India-US trade deal falls through. So this is regarding the trade deal, the mini deal which was proposed to be concluded between India and USA while Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi is in USA. So the UN General Assembly meet is scheduled in New York, and also the Howdy Modi meet took place in USA, where both the leaders, Modi and Mr. Trump, they jointly address the Indian diaspora. So on the sidelines of this, it was expected a mini trade deal could be negotiated. Even Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal was present in New York to conclude the trade package with US trade representative, but the two sides could not agree. You can see it is mentioned here, Indian tariffs on information and communication technology proved the sticking point. So here you can see the demands which USA had are mentioned. US wants India to eliminate tariffs on ICT, information communication technology products. There's 20% tariff on ICT. But then India is not ready for this. India is concerned that this could open up the market to flooding by Chinese technology. So you should know that if India reduces tariffs, it reduces tariffs in general. Because under World Trade Organization, every nation should provide every other nation with MFN status, most favored nation status. So there should not be any preferential treatment. If you are giving some favor to one country, it has to be given to every other country. Every country should be MFN. So that's the idea. So this was the sticking point. Other demands which USA has is it wants greater access to Indian markets for medical devices such as stents and knee implants, of course for ICT also, and dairy products. It wanted to remove the cap. There are price caps on medical devices, so US sought to remove these price caps. You can see these are called trade margin rationalization. So, and also for dairy products, it wanted greater access in India along with other category of agricultural products for which it wanted greater access. What were India's demands? India wanted reinstatement of the preferential market access to US markets under GSP, Generalized System of Preferences. We should recollect that this GSP status for India was revoked in June 2019. So India wants reinstatement of this status so that it can get preferential market access to USA. So GSP is actually for developing countries. So USA said that India does not need this, but then India wants this to be reinstated. Also, India wants facilitation of processes in agricultural product markets. In agricultural product markets, we already have access, but what India wants is easier certification of food product, irradiation facilities, etc. Then also it wants greater access in some agricultural markets like table grapes, pomegranates, etc. This was there, but finally we saw that India and USA could not agree on all the matters. Then this is Johnson unlawfully suspended Parliament. So this is UK Supreme Court which has ruled that British Prime Minister Boris Johnson's decision to shut down Parliament for 5 weeks before Brexit was unlawful. So he did it so that he has the final say and deciding power to on Brexit. So this was unanimous decision by 11 presiding judges in the Supreme Court of USA. So we have seen this, he had suspended Parliament, you can see, from September 10 to October 14. And October 31 is when the Brexit is scheduled to take place. So it meant that there would not be enough time for the legislators to have any law passed on Brexit. Because he has promised to leave the European Union on October 31 with or without a deal. But then the Parliament commenced and Parliament has ruled that Brexit would take place only with a deal, and that is a diverse deal or a Brexit deal with the European Union. That what would be the future relation between Britain and EU after Britain exits EU. So the divorce deal is important. Otherwise, you can see that British Parliament has ruled that Brexit should be delayed. So this has already happened, but because he suspended the Parliament, he did not want all this to happen. The step he took is actually saw a rebuke from Supreme Court, and you can see the Supreme Court says that this suspension of Parliament was unlawful. So it had, you know, extreme effects on fundamentals of democracy. Then below you have 26 dead, 300 injured as quake jolts Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. So, powerful 5.8 magnitude earthquake jolted Pakistan-occupied Kashmir and several cities in the northwestern parts of India. So, it has resulted in killing of at least 26 people and over 300 others have been wounded. So even it is Pakistan Meteorological Department which said that this, the worst hit areas were Mirpur, where houses had collapsed and roads were ripped apart. So this is Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, where you can see what has happened. So this is an earthquake in POK. Then this is no more waste mounds on Siachen. So since January 2018, nearly 130 tons of waste has been brought down from the Siachen Glacier and disposed of. So this is a 2018 concept note on waste management on the glacier, under which army has made bringing down waste a part of SOP, standard operating procedure for troops. So it said on an average 236 tons of waste is generated every year on Siachen Glacier. But there is now an SOP for every link patrol or administrative column to bring the waste down. And it is said the capacity of each person to carry is 10 to 15 kg due to extreme weather. So this is there. You can see it was in 1984 under Operation Meghdoot that India occupied the glacier, Siachen Glacier. So, and it has held this glacier since then. So, it is said to be the highest battlefield in the world where India and Pakistan are actually having claims. So, you can see this is 130 tons disposed of waste, which includes biodegradable and non-biodegradable metallic, non-metallic waste. It is said the biggest challenge was the high altitude, because most posts were located between 18,000 to 21,000 feet and nothing degrades at sub-zero temperature, so everything has to be brought down. So there are three types of waste to be disposed: biodegradable, non-biodegradable, non-biodegradable, non-metallic. And then, of course, you have, the metallic waste. On page 8, you have utility lines to Marudu homes to be cut. So, this is, as you can see, this is regarding Marudu in Kerala. The apartments, the building which has come up along the coastal regulations, regulatory zone, violating the norms. So, Supreme Court has also asked for it being raised down. But residents are not ready to vacate. So now Kerala State Electricity Board has been asked to snap power supply as such. So the order in the case will also come. And you can see other service providers have also been asked to disconnect their utility supplies so that residents vacate. And this is Ramanujan Prize for UK Mathematician. So this is Sastra Ramanujan Prize for 2019, which will be awarded to mathematician Adam Harper. He's assistant professor with University of Warwick, England. So prize has a citation and award of $10,000. It is conferred annually on mathematicians from across the world who are less than 32 years of age and working in an area influenced by the genius Srinivas Ramanujan. It was instituted in 2005 and is among the top 5 awards of its type in mathematics. You can see Mr. Harper was awarded the prize for several outstanding contributions to analytic and probabilistic number theory. And this is police gear up to scan underworld of internet. So, expert from Israel trains Kerala Cyberdome analyst to monitor the darknet. So, Kerala police is having its state-of-the-art lab to crack down rising criminal activities over darknet, that is known as the underworld of the internet. So, you should know about it. We have seen quite often how, like an iceberg, the internet which we see is only 10% of the actual entire internet. So, there is deep net and then darknet. Like, darknet is something which requires special, access. It is not accessible to all in general. Then below you have Krishna water for Chennai from today. So Andhra Pradesh government has decided to release Krishna water to Chennai in Tamil Nadu from today on a priority basis. So initially 500 cusecs will be released and discharge will be scaled up to 2000 cusecs gradually. So this is regarding this discharge. On page 9, you have Center mulling stock limits for onions. So the onion prices are increasing and the center is considering imposing stock limits on the kitchen staple, but it is also worried about the impact on farmers in poll bound states. So decision is likely to impact farmers too if there are limits put on onion. So major onion producer is Maharashtra and it is leading to the polls in less than a month. So if government takes hasty action on imposing stock limits, it could be accused of being against farmers' interests. So yeah, you can see the retail price of onions range from 44 to 90 a kg in major cities according to National Horticulture Board, maximum being in Hyderabad. Then this is Dada Saheb Phalke Award for Amitabh Bachchan. So the country's highest film honor, Dada Saheb Phalke Award, has been conferred for outstanding contribution for the growth and development of Indian cinema. It will be conferred on Shri Amitabh Bachchan for 2019. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Climate for Action. So this is regarding the UN Climate Action Summit, which took place in New York. Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed here. It is on the sidelines of UN General Assembly meet that such summits have taken place. So here, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced that we would be scaling up electricity from renewables from 175 gigawatts by 2020 to even 450 gigawatts. We saw yesterday front page news that it would be more than doubled, the target for renewable energy. So such are the claims being made, but then this has to be matched with domestic measures, because Prime Minister, when he addressed the international community in Houston, the Howdy Modi meet, at that time he has said that the government has opened coal mining to 100% FDI, which of course climate activists are opposed to. They clearly oppose this announcement too, because climate activists are campaigning for ban on new coal plants and divestment of shares in coal companies. So that is there. So you can see advancing national climate agenda in the spirit of the words which he has used in his speech is essential. The editorial says that existing internal framework, that is National Action Plan on Climate Change, is more than a decade old. So it needs to be revised, and mission mode programs should be in place to convert the words into actions. And this is Balakot Redux. So this was also front page news yesterday about how terrorists are regrouping, and Balakot training camp, a terrorist camp in Pakistan, is again seeing people coming and activity there. So that is all information through satellites as such. So Army Chief Bipin Rawat has said that we may take severe action now. It may not just be an airstrike, but a severe action may be taken here at Balakot. But then the editorial says that evidently the strike on terrorists in Pakistan did not have a lasting impact. Balakot is again filled with activity. The lead article, another chance in Afghanistan. So this is regarding how US President Donald Trump, he called off Taliban peace talks. So this article says that this is to India's advantage. It's that US Taliban talks were called off. So an outreach to the outfit as such would secure a deal as such, and that would have kept India out, because even Afghan government was out of these talks, and talks with Taliban would be facilitated by Pakistan. So Pakistan had a more of a role to play, but then since these talks have collapsed, that has given India an advantage. And this is defeated, discredited and diminished. So this is regarding British Prime Minister Boris Johnson. We saw the front page news about how the British Supreme Court has called out Prime Minister Johnson's decision to prorogue Parliament, and it has been called a constitutional earthquake going against the principles of democracy. Then on op-ed page, you have the attack on agroecology. So this says powerful lobbies with vested interests see agroecology as a threat to their influence on farming systems. So agroecology actually enhances fertile landscapes, increases yields, and even restores soil health and biodiversity. It promotes climate resilience as well, improves farmers' well-being. but its practices, which are supported by many agricultural scientists, are opposed by farming systems as such. So farmers' organizations, you know, are opposing it, is highlighted here, you can see. So you can see zero budget natural farming, ZBNF, which has been developed and publicized by agro scientist Subhash Palekar. It has been adopted by Andhra Pradesh, but farmers groups have sent letters to Prime Minister opposing zero-based natural farming. So the elites here in the system, the agricultural sector, they are having powerful lobbies and vested interests. They don't want agroecology to flourish, as it would threaten their existence. So that is detailed out here. On page 13, you have PM seeks stronger FATF to curb terror. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has called to avoid politicization of the Financial Action Task Force mechanisms and has asked it to curb terror. But Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan sees it as an Indian agenda against Pakistan. So you should know about Financial Action Task Force, which takes action against money laundering and terror financing, and it has already grey listed Pakistan twice. And if Pakistan does not fulfill the conditions to take action against terror financing and money laundering, then it would be blacklisted. That would affect its banking and financial systems. Then this is no normalcy in Jammu and Kashmir, says fact finding team of women. So it says this fact finding team, you know, has refuted government's claims of normalcy in Kashmir and says that boys as young as 14 or 15 are taken away and tortured, and young women complain of harassment by army men. On international page, you have a setback to Boris Johnson. So this is regarding the front page news about the Supreme Court of UK ruling that the action taken by Boris Johnson to suspend British Parliament was incorrect. It was a blow to democracy. Then on business page, you have India accepts RCEP tips on investments. So India has not yet signed RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement, but it has accepted suggestions of other countries regarding rules on investments. So India and other RCEPs are currently in the final stage of negotiations on it in Vietnam. So it has agreed, India has agreed to several provisions that bring it in line with the investment rules applicable to most comparable countries. Like, you know, so this is like mandating that investing companies transfer technology and train their domestic partners, removing caps on quantum of royalties domestic companies can pay their foreign partners. And also, you know, if the RCEP agreement is signed, these rules are expected to attract greater investment in India as well. So there are 16 RCEP countries, that is 10 ASEAN countries, Association of Southeast Asian Nations, and China, Japan, South Korea, Australia, India, and New Zealand. So these are the 16 nations amongst which RCEP has been negotiated. So actually, Indian laws currently have the provision wherein companies investing in a country can be made to transfer technology or know-how to their domestic counterparts. So government and RBI are currently imposing a cap on royalties a domestic company can pay to its foreign parent or partner for certain kinds of investments. But what is being said is this cap should be removed. It will attract more investment. So India has accepted these tips on investments and will take action accordingly. Then this is RBI places withdrawal curbs on depositors of PMC bank. So this is regarding Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. So in a surprising move, RBI has imposed restrictions here. So depositors cannot withdraw more than 1,000 from their accounts now. So directions have been imposed under Banking Regulation Act 1949. It also bars the lender from extending any fresh loan or making any investments except in government securities. So move has come as a surprise because banks' financials were not in a bad shape. It has a net profit. So net NPA of the bank was also at 2.19%, much lower than many public sector banks. So such a decision has come as a shock for Pune and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. below you have insurers can tweak health products. So Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India has okayed collecting premium in installments, increasing maximum entry age as well. So this is going to make it easier for health insurers to tweak certain features of the cover provided to individuals. So, you know, collection of premium in installments, increasing the maximum entry age as such. So this is there. Then there's no other important news. So these are the important headlines which we discussed so far. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.